I'm going to recite to you today two poems that are written by our beloved Manx poet T. Brown. Thomas Edward Brown was born on 5th May 1830 and died 29th of October 1897. He was a Manx poet, scholar, and was born in the Isle of Man and educated at King William's College. Brown was a great walker, and his short guide, written for his friend James Brown, owner of the Isle of Man Times, makes interesting reading. Though I doubt if the walks could be followed today. Dr. Brown was certainly one of the great letter writers. In his letters, we find himself, his vivid personality, his large-heartedness, and knowledge of human nature, his keen sense of humour, and his deep religious feeling. The first poem I'm going to recite to you is called Climbing, and is one of the less well-known ones. When I would get me to the upper fields, I look, if anywhere, a man be found who craves for joy seagulls, the keen thin air, who loves the rapture of the height, and fain would snatch with me a perilous delight. I wait and linger on the village street, and long for one to come and say, the morning's bright, it is not meet that thou the home of vulgar life shouldst leave, and seek the view alone from those great peaks. I surely will go through. But not to me comes our any man, or if he comes, dull sleep still thickens in his eyes, so that to scan the beckoning steep he has no power, and of its scornful cone unconscious sits him down, and I go alone. Yet children are performing on the slope, their dew bedabbled prints press the black fern roots naked, dark red, sunny hope, and glints upon their hair, but devious they remain among the baby beds, and I go on again. And so there is no help for it, no nymph to share the arduous way. Nevertheless, I must ascend, ere it grow late, and dim, and grey. The final cloud that struck my soul's endeavour, and I see nothing more forever and forever. The second poem is one of his very well known ones, and I'm sure many people have it framed as hanging on their wall. Betsy Lee. Now the beauty of the thing when childer blazes, the terrible wonderful length of the days is. Up he jumps, and out in the sun, and you fancy the day will never be done. And he chasing the bumpies, running so cross, in the hot sweet air among the grass, or rat gathering bluebells, or looking for eggs, or pelting the ducks with their yellow legs, or climbing and nearly breaking his skulls, or shouting for dibblement after the gulls, or thinking of nothing but down at the tide, singing out for the happier feeling side. That's the way of the kids, you know, and the years do come, and the years do go. And when you look back, it's all like a book, happy and over, and short enough.
Thank you.